So if you're going to read comments, you're opening yourself up to that. If you're going to get your opinion swayed by people who just want to see if they can affect you, just want to see if they can fuck with you.
They can touch you.
Just see if they can change you, get you to change the way you're dressing.
And that's what I don't like. That's the part I don't like. So I tell all of my artists and all my friends, don't change. Don't read it. Because what happens is everybody starts coloring inside the lines, and now nobody's dangerous anymore.
Right.
Because you remember back in the day, Madonna, dangerous. Boom.
Right.
Madonna come out naked, you know, just dancing to the Grammys like it's all good. You know what I'm saying? So what I hope, what I always say, just don't tuck your art in. Don't tuck your art in for the comments, because we'll end up not having anything to celebrate that is good. Like having something to celebrate. Somebody did a song that was dope, or a movie that was dope, or got outside the box, as opposed to what we love celebrating, which is the crazy shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, especially for comics.
Yeah.
Because it's one per. If you do a crazy movie, there's a lot of people involved.
Yeah.
If you're on stage and you say something fucked up, it's just you.
Yeah. Well, I'm going back out, so it's about to happen. I'm gonna be passing out a whole bunch of gift baskets. Because I'm going back out, and
How much time did you take off?
I'm never actually taken off, because I still do gigs. Like, I got a gig tomorrow, St. Louis, you know, private gig, whatever. But it's just, you know, like I know, like, as a comedian, you got to live. Like, I just can't jump out there and just start talking or writing jokes. Like, I've lived through some crazy shit, so I got to go out there and talk about that. You know, had I not, I'd be like, oh. Because the one thing I hate is, the one thing that's tough for a comedian is to become successful. Because we talk from a shit is fucked up point of view, and I got to have a little anger, and I got to have a little poke fun. And if I become that, if I become what I poke fun at, then I can't get it off. That's why at my house, people come to my house, my daughter used to ask me this, Dad, why is this room not, there's nothing in it? I said, I don't want to complete the house, because it gives me a sense of, like, I'm still trying to get on. Like, I don't put like all the pictures, nothing is like perfect in my crib. There's a curtain right now that's torn open in my bedroom. And they be like, what's going on with Jay Foxx, man? What's going on? You're not getting them checks, man? What's going on? And I just said, I just got to leave it like that. I keep my house a little sort of, we call
it
the dysfunctional mansion. I talk about that. The dysfunctional mansion, where there's always somebody, like the other night, there's Odell Beckham in my house, battle dancing Chris Brown. You know what I'm saying? Like, who does that? You know what I'm saying? I just crazy shit happening at my house all the time, so I have something to link my, you know, hitch my comedic wagon to.
So you create chaos on purpose in a little bit of a way.
I just leave it.
Slight disarray.
I don't remove myself from it. I don't get behind the gates. Behind the gates is the worst shit.
Behind the gates.
Behind the gates. When you get behind the gates, when you reach a certain point and you're behind the gates, you can't really see. I'm out. I got to be out with the people. I got to have people. Like, I had a BET party, right? 3,000 people at my house. Counted.
Jesus.
People at the gate, you know, trying to get in. And as I look through the party, there's Floyd Mayweather. All time. Y'all, you know, what's up, Jay Foxx? What's up, baby? How you doing? All time. You got the greatest party. I love you, baby. You know, got the fight coming, Jay. You know, so there's Floyd. There's Fat Joe. There's Little Kim is on stage performing. And then I look around, and I see some of the homies, like the real guys, like, what's up, Foxx? Hey, this is a nice party right here, cuz. Love it. I'm like, oh, shit. So it's all of these mixtures of people that I can still touch, hang out with, people from my community. Her name is Anka. She's like the unofficial mayor in our cities. Old little white lady from Germany. And she's on the dance floor dancing with Snoop. Oh, I love it, Snoopy. He's great. The Snoopy is so good in the weed. I don't know it. It's crazy. So wow. I sort of keep it that way so I can stay loose. So when I go out, I got shit that I could talk about from the hood to the White House.
So you still manage to stay a regular person.
Got to.
But that's a hard thing. For someone who's achieved as much success as you have, that is not an easy balancing act. To stay normal, because you must get overwhelmed by requests and people just wanting your time and wanting to hitch themselves to you. And
but you gotta look. I think what helps me is the failures, like doing a couple of movies that don't. What was that?
Right.
You know what I'm saying, like, damn, Foxx. You know what I'm saying? Going through TSA, they don't speak to you. Your movie is out, and they're like, come on through. They don't even make eye contact. Come on through. All right, good. Going through. Damn, the movie sucked. So, or you just get the TSA. Get, damn, Foxx, what you doing, baby? What was that shit? This last shit, dog. I had to watch that shit on Fire Stick, my nigga.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, that. So it's like you appreciate those,
right?
Which keeps you regular, keeps you humble, and you just gotta sort of look at other people and see how people in our business, when they do get behind the gates, you know, you've seen comics that get that 1,000-mile stare and
yeah.
don't want. I don't be funny no more.
Yeah.
Why don't you be funny no more? That's how you came up. I want to be sexy now. You know what I'm saying? They all fall into the sexy. You know, nah, I want to stay funny, keep the teeth goofy, keep my head looking goofy, hairline, whatever it is, because that's what I draw upon when I go out, because people can sense it. Don't you think?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think stand-up is kind of, in some ways, it's like a mind meld or a mass hypnosis. Like, you're connecting with the audience, and if there's anything false about what you're thinking or what you're saying, some of them, at least, can feel it.
Yeah.
Sometimes all of them, but some of them can feel it, and it'll fuck with the energy of the room. But if you're in the groove, you're really being yourself. That's why when you see Dave on stage, one of the things about Chappelle is that he's always himself.
Yeah.
He can just be himself. Yeah. And so you relax as an audience member and slide right into his mind, and he takes you on a journey.
Right.
Because he's himself. He's not disconnected by fame and celebrity. And that way... He was genius how he passed up all that money and just went to Africa and just settled in and then came back and didn't do any scheduled gigs for years. Yeah. He would show up with a speaker and set up a speaker in a park in like Seattle and just gather a crowd around and start doing stand-up.
Yeah, man. See, but that's what I'm saying. It's like, how do you find that?